Okay, we have done this practical before also in chemistry lab as well, previous week as well. Okay, so I'm just going to brush up the things which you must have, which I have already told, and we are going to continue it. So these are the list of practicals which we are going to perform. So first practical is the determination of pH. Okay, now this pH practical you have already performed in chemistry as well, or not only the chemistry in primary section as well, but at that time you are not using the electronic pH which you have used. You basically use that pH paper in which you must have learned that if you use this pH paper, then the either the red litmus paper turns blue or the blue litmus paper turns red. Only the these things you have learned in the primary, but these are not the things which can give the exact result. For getting the exact result, what we are going to do, we are going to use the either the pH meter or any digital pH meter for that purpose. Okay, in this practical, as I already told you about all these things, so this is the pH meter which we are going to use for this purpose. So the same specification and the same equipment is also available in our college as well. Okay, this is called as the pH meter, and this is called as this tube, which is we are going to, which is it is either called as a tube or the electrode in electrode which we are going to dip inside the liquid of which we have to calculate the pH of. Okay, so these are the one of the equipment. Another equipment is this one. This is also the digital pH meter. This is more handy. Okay, most of the in the domestic purpose we are using this one, but as far as laboratory experiments are concerned, we mostly use this pH meter. Okay, because this much gives the most reliable values as well, and not by using the this digital pH meter. If you have to calculate the pH meter roughly, so if now that it's showing 5.78, so it doesn't mean that the pH of that particular sample is 5.78. It might be goes to 5.6 or 5.5 or even 6. Okay, we can't totally rely on this, but for domestic purpose, or if we don't require the pH to be more exact, then we can use this pH meter. Okay, next, these are the apparatus which we are going to use in most of our practicals, so I'm just going to list it out some of it. So these are the first I'm going to show you what are the titration equipment, because in the most of the practicals which we are going to perform, we are going to use the titration equipment. So first is the pipette with elongated tip. Okay, this is the pipette. What is the use of pipette? Pipette is used to draw the chemical from. Okay, next is this measuring cylinder. This measuring cylinder is used to measure the amount of liquid or amount of solution which we have to take on. Next is the standard flask. Next is this wash bottle. Now what is the use of wash bottle? Most of the time we are not going to use the basin for that purpose. So what we are going to do, we are going to use this wash bottle. We are taking the water from it, and mostly this water, inside this bottle we are going to place the distilled water. Okay, now I have already told you what is the meaning of distilled water. It is either called as distilled water or deionized water or pure water. Okay, we can call any of the three things. So what is the use of this distilled water? Basically, distilled water is totally neutral water. Okay, so when we are going to use it, so that to clean the apparatus as well, so we don't require any kind of other chemicals which is being present. If you are going to use the tap water for that purpose, so what will happen, sometimes whatever the chemicals or whatever the minerals which is being present in the tap water is going to get in the readings as well. So what we are going to use, we are always going to use the distilled water for cleaning the apparatus as well. Next comes this pipette bulb. Now this pipette bulb is also used to draw the chemicals from. Now this is conical flask. Basically this conical flask is placed at the bottom of this burette stand. What is the use of this conical flask? Basically to take the chemicals and going to stir it properly. Next comes the beaker. Beaker is also used to store the chemicals or to take the chemicals. And last one is this burette stand. Okay, what is the use of this? This is called as the burette, and this is the burette stand. Okay, in this burette, basically what we are going to use, we are going to add this chemical and we are going to drip it down at the tip of it. Okay, we don't require to add the chemical instantly. So what we are going to do, we have to add the chemicals drop by drop. So we can't use this by using this beaker and all. Okay. So that for that purpose, what we are going to use, we are going to use this burette. Okay. And this is a burette stand in which this burette has to be fixed. And last one is, this is the porcelain tile. Okay. Now, hello. Okay. So what is this porcelain tile? Whenever we check any color of the chemical, we always use the white color against it. Say, for example, if you are using against the, say, for example, this is what? This is blue color. Okay. If we are going to see the chemical against this blue color, then what will happen? We are not able to see the color properly. But if we are going to see any color against this white color, so that, so whatever the color which we required or which we have seen is clearly been visible. Okay. That's why we are mostly use this porcelain white tile. Okay. So these are the apparatus which we are going to use for that purpose. Next, this is the pH. I already teach about this theory in the previous lecture as well. Okay. To just brush it up, I just want to tell you, this is the aqueous solution. Whenever we check the pH, we always check the pH at the 25 degree Celsius. 25 degree Celsius is the temperature we consider to be the constant. Okay. So at 25 degrees Celsius, pH less than 7, we consider it as acidic. If it is more than 7, we consider it as basic. And if it is 7, then we consider it as a neutral. Okay. So pH level 7 is defined to be the neutral at 25 degrees Celsius, because at this pH, the concentration of hydrogen ion equals to the concentration of OH ion, or which is called as a hydroxyl ion in a pure water. So hydrogen ion concentration and OH ion concentration, it's equal. That's why we call it to be neutral. Next, pH reading of the solution is usually obtained by comparing the known solution to those of the unknown pH. Okay. Whenever we used to check something, we always had to check with respect to something. Okay. We can't consider anything to be the standard. Okay. So that's why we have to calibrate the equipment. Okay. Why is it necessary to calibrate the equipment? For that purpose. We can't consider anything with the standard. We have to consider with something. And this something is to be the standard one. Okay. Say, for example, we have taken two samples. One is to be standard, and second thing, we have to calculate it. So we can't consider the equipment to be the standard. We consider this solution to be the standard. Okay. This solution is not going to change, because the proportion, whatever the chemicals we are going to add in this solution, is going to be the constant, but not the equipment. Okay, so these are the two different things. Equipment is not constant, but this solution is. So we are always going to calibrate with respect to this solution. Next comes the theoretical things. Okay, what is the formula for pH? pH is nothing but the negative logarithmic of the hydrogen ion concentration. Okay, pH is a negative base 10 logarithm of the hydrogen ion concentration of the solution. We always have to consider this negative logarithmic. Okay. Now there are two types of logarithm. First is logarithm log with base 10, and there is another log which is called as the ln
log with base e.
Log with base e, exactly, which is also we write it at ln, which is called as the natural log. Right?
Natural log.
So whenever we are calculating this, we always going to use this logarithmic base 10. Okay. In definition itself, we have said the negative base of 10 logarithm. Okay. Base logarithm with base 10. Okay. Of hydrogen ion concentration. That is the pH. So now what is POH? Sorry. Right. POH is what? POH is nothing but
concentration of OH ion.
Right. Concentration of OH ion, but negative. Minus log base 10.
Minus
can concentration of OH ion. OH negative. Okay. So this is the POH. And you all also known this, the fact that pH, concentration of pH plus POH equals to what?
Sir, the pH plus POH is always equal to 14.
14.
Exactly. 14. Okay. You know about it. Okay. So pH plus POH is always going to equals to 14. Right. Next is this pH chart. Everybody knows about this pH chart, and most of the liquids or most of the solution, you must remember its pH as well. Okay. So I'm just listed out some of it. So from we are going to go from the bottom to top. Okay. 1 pH is the most acidic and 14 pH is most basic. Okay. Remember this. So most acidic is what? Battery acid, sulfuric acid, soda drink, acidic lake, clean rain and healthy lakes. These are what it is, nothing but the acidic thing. And also the juice which is being present inside your stomach, it's also pH, is also acidic, and its pH ranges from 1 to 3. Okay, remember this. Whatever we required the food to be digest inside, and for that digestion purpose we required acid. I guess it's always told that not to sleep on the right hand side, otherwise this acid is going to reflux back into our pipe, or whatever it is called, as the endo something pipe something. Okay, so that's also the pH which has the higher which is the pH having the least, sorry, what it is, it is least pH. Okay, pH value ranges from 1 to 3 over there. Okay, now next, what are the things which is acidic to us, basic to us? It is nothing but the sea water, baking soda, milk of magnesia, ammonia, soapy water, bleach, and highly alkaline liquid drain cleaner, which is all these are the high basic or highly alkaline solution. Okay, remember all these things. There are even in most of the GATE examination, they just ask what is the pH of blood. Okay, so what is the pH of blood? We don't know about it. So basically just go through some of the liquids or some of the solution which we are using day-to-day life or which we have seen in day-to-day life, and just see what is the pH of that particular thing. Okay, so this is also one of the important factor, not only for the engineering prospect but also for the medical and the other humanities prospect as well. Okay, so make sure you remember the pH of most of the solution. Next comes the IS code. Okay, standard recommendation for the drinking water. Now we are constrained for only drinking purpose. What, whenever we talk about the pH, we are concerned about the pH of water which we are going to drink. Okay, the optimum pH for a drinking water of excellent quality would be 7 to 8.5. this is just normal thing, but different institution has given their different desirable range. So IS code, Indian BIS, Bureau of Indian Standard, has given the range to be 6.5 to 8.5, and there is maximum permissible range. They have not given any relaxation to it. Okay, so whenever we talk about the pH, drinking water pH, we always have the value in between 6.5 to 8.5. next comes WHO, World Health Organization, has given the desirable range to be 7 to 8.5. okay, and maximum permissible range they have given 6.5 to 9.2. okay, so as far as our BIS is concerned, we are always go for our Indian standard. Okay, 6.5 to 8.5, remember this value. Okay, I'm going to share some of the test characteristics for the drinking water as per IS 10500 2012. Last session I have told you some IS code, and there has listed so many of the parameters. So out of all these parameters, you don't have to remember each and every thing of it. So I have listed total 30 parameters. Okay, so you have to remember this 30 parameters by heart. Okay, whenever anyone has asked you what is the pH value, and you have to tell the acceptable range, it is to be 6.5 to 8.5. okay, you don't have to mistaken in any of it. You don't have to consider any WHO standard specifically. You always have to follow the IS code rules. Okay, say for example, what is a dissolved solid in mg per liter? It has given 500 mg per liter, and permissible limit in the absence of alternate source, then it is equals to 2000 mg per liter. So these are the things you have to remember. These are for the environmental one. Okay, these are what characteristics for the drinking water. Remember this. This first page is only for drinking water, and there is one second page also which is concerned to the environmental engineering too. So in next semester we are going to learn the environmental engineering too. There we are learning about the sewage and discharge of the sewage and the industrial effluent in the surface water and the public sewers. Okay, in next semester we are going to learn about all these things. So you don't have to consider all these things right now. Just consider only this 30 parameters. Okay. So remember this 30 parameters by heart. Okay. First of all, what we had to do, we are going to use this electronic pH meter. Okay. In this pH meter, first, what we had to do, first we had to switch on the pH meter at least 30 minutes before the test. Why we are doing 30 minutes before the test? So that each and everything is going to get started. Okay. Sometimes it takes a little bit more time to overcome or heat purpose. Okay. So before perform this practical, we have to switch on this equipment. After doing so, we have to prepare the buffer solution of pH 4, 7 and 9.2. Now, what is this buffer solution? Buffers are compound or mixture of a compound that by their presence in the solution resists the change in the pH upon the addition of small quantities of acid and alkali. So what is the meaning of buffer solution? Buffer solution are a solution in which the solution of a pH is going to be the constant. Even we are going to add any acid or alkali into it, the pH is not going to change. So why we are going to use for the calibration purpose. Okay. So for calibration purpose, we are going to use this three buffer solution. Okay. Buffer solution of 4, 7 and 9.2. Now the question arises, how the buffer solution are made, or do we get direct buffer solution directly from market? No, you are not going to get this. How we are going to get this buffer solution? For that purpose, there are some buffer tablets available in the market. Okay. These are the buffer tablets of pH 7. Okay. These are 20 tablets is being present in this box. Okay. So now how to use this buffer solution? First, what we have to do? First, we have to take a beaker. In this beaker, we have to take the 100 ml of distilled water. 100 ml of distilled water or pure water into it. Okay. Now, what is the pure water? Pure water is a water which has the pH 7, and in that solution, we don't have any minerals or any chemicals into it. So this is a totally pure water. It has nothing in it. Okay, so how much we have taken? We have taken 100 ml of pure water, and after that we are going to get some capsules. Okay, in this bottle we are going to get some capsules, and you have to add one capsule into this solution. After adding this capsule into the solution, we have to stir it well properly till the whole capsule is going to get dissolved into this pure water. After it is being dissolved into the pure water, what we have to do? We are going to get this solution to be as a buffer solution. Okay. Now, what is this buffer solution? This is a buffer solution having pH 7.0. Okay. Remember this. So similarly, like this buffer solution, we also have to prepare another buffer solution which has pH 9.2 and another buffer solution which has pH 4. So for that purpose, what we are going to do, we are going to use the tablets which has the buffer solution, buffer tablets having the pH 9.2 and 4. This is how we have to make the buffer solution. Okay. After that, we have prepared this buffer solution. After that, what we have to do? First, the whole practical is simple, but before that, we have to calibrate this equipment. So the calibration process is more than the testing process. Okay. After making this buffer solution, what we have to do? We have to do the calibration. Now, how to calibrate it? Calibrate the pH to 9.2 using the buffer solution and by adjusting the calibration knob. Okay. So how to do this? After dipping this electrode into this solution, what we are to do? We are going to get some readings. Okay, we are not going to get the exact 9.2 reading. So what we are going to do? We are going to remove this knob. Okay, we have to rotate this knob till it becomes 9.2. As soon as it becomes 9.2, we can say that it is partially calibrated. It's not fully calibrated. It's partially being calibrated. After that, we are going to remove this solution, and then this electrode is being washed with the distilled water. Remember this. This electrode is to be washed with the distilled water. After doing so, what we have to do? Now we again have to calibrate with the different buffer solution. Now, which buffer solution we are going to use? We are going to use the buffer solution which has the pH 7. Now the question arises, the pure water also has the buffer, also has the pH 7, and this buffer solution having pH 7 also has the pH 7. Now why we are using this buffer solution having pH 7? So basically why we have used, as I already told you, what is the buffer solution? Even whatever the buffer solution is, a solution in which even though we add the acid or alkali or any basic solution to it, the pH is not going to change. So to make the thing constant, we are going to use this buffer solution. Okay. Someone has started. Thank you, madam. So after you making this buffer solution, we again have to calibrate it. Now after dipping this electrode, what we are going to get? We are going to get some readings into it. It's not necessary that we are going to get the readings to be 7. So for that purpose, what we have to do? We again have to rotate this knob. Now after rotating this knob, what we are going to get? We have to rotate the knob till it becomes 7. As soon as it becomes 7, we can say that it's again going to get calibrated. Okay. After doing so, we again have to do the same calibration. But before that, what we have to do? We have to make sure that we are going to wash this electrode with a pure water. After washing this electrode, we again going to use this buffer solution having pH 4 and going to dip this electrode into this solution and calibrate the pH of 4 using the buffer solution by adjusting the calibration knob. And again, we have to do the same thing by calibrating the knob if we are not going to get the reading to be 4.0. After doing all these things, we can say that our equipment is being calibrated. Okay. Now, if you are going to use the same thing, if you are going to use this buffer solution 9.2 and going to check it, you are almost going to get the 9.2 or 9.1. There is always going to get some error. There is always error being associated with any equipment. Okay. So we can say this, the equipment is totally being calibrated. Now the equipment is going to be used. So for using purpose, what we are going to do? We are first going to take a sample. Okay. Now in this yellow thing, you can see this. This is a sample. First, what we have to do? We have to pour this sample into this bottle, into this beaker. After that, we have to dip this electrode for some time. After dipping the electrode, the reading start fluctuating. It's not going to get directly the constantly. Okay. Say for example, if we are going to get the pH 9, it's not going to directly goes to the 9. It slowly goes to the 1, 2, 3, 3.2, 4, 5, 6, 5. Then it takes some time to give the constant reading. After it gives the constant reading, now the reading is going to stop. Then we can say that the pH of that particular solution to be the X, Y, Z. Okay. Say for example, after using this, we are going to get the pH to be 12.2. Now what we can say that now the pH of this sample is 9.2 and the solution is basic. Okay. It's not acidic, it's a basic. So this is the whole procedure of this, how we are going to calculate this pH of the solution. Okay. Understood? So this is how we have to calculate the pH. Okay. Next, after doing this is the observation table. Okay. Now see the observation table. We don't have to do so much in the observation table. First is the serial number 1, 2, 3. Next is the description of sample. And last one is this pH value. Now what is the description of sample? Whenever we are going to use the any solution for the purpose of calculating its pH, we have to write the detail about it. We can't just write going to say it's a tap water or it's a dirty water or it's something like that. We have to specify the things about it. So say for example, if it is a tap water, we are going to use the tap water from where you have been collected and from which municipality it's of. Okay. Say for example, if it's the Mumbai, then you are going to write the BMC or something like that and tap water. Okay, if it's from some different city, say for example, Nashik or Pune, so you are going to write the description of it. You are not going to write just a tap water. You have to specify from where you have procured this tap water from. Okay, and after that, you have to write the pH value of it. Okay, the pH value, if it comes 12.2, you are going to write it 12.2 and everything. So this is how you have to make the observation table. And last one is the result. The pH value of the given sample by using the electromagnetic method is dash dash. So whatever the things which we have taken is what we have to write it down. Okay. What if it is now more acidic or more basic? First, pH has no direct effect on health. However, a lower pH value 4 will produce a sour taste, and higher value above 8.5 gives the bitter taste. So you don't want to drink a water which has a sour taste value or a bitter taste. Bitter taste. Okay, so this is one of the environmental significance as far as the drinking purpose is concerned. Okay, so high pH indicates the formation of the trihalomethanes, which are causing cancer in the human being. So if we are going to drink the high pH, then ultimately it will produce some carcinogenic agents. It is nothing but a cancer causing agents.